In this lesson, we're going to cover keyword clustering. This is the crucial step to transition between keyword research and content planning. Let's begin with a definition. Keyword clustering is the process of creating groups of keywords that are semantically linked to target a page. Let me explain. Back in the early days of the web, when search engines were very simple, you would target the keywords green apples and red apples separately. It was common practice to create two pages of almost identical content, one targeting green apples and the other red apples. In a way, it was necessary if you wanted to rank for both keywords because search engines treated each keyword separately and independently. And by the way, that's where the legacy term keyword comes from. It really was about one keyword at a time. Today, however, search engines are smarter. The algorithms have evolved to connect keywords that are related semantically or otherwise. So if you were creating an article about the benefits of eating apples, red apples and green apples would be related keywords in the same group, or cluster. You would then create just one page that included information about both red and green apples and any other related keywords in your cluster. The upshot of this is that one page today can rank for many keywords. In fact, a well-optimized page can rank for hundreds of related terms. The potential for massive traffic is tremendous, and working this way is certainly a lot easier than creating hundreds of pages targeting one keyword each. And this brings us to something called topical authority. Bookmark this section because this is a game changer. Topical authority is a semantic SEO strategy. It's a turning point in old-school SEO, adapting to how search engines are evolving. Instead of optimizing content around keywords, we should now focus on optimizing content around entire topics. For example, take the anti-aging topic. There are many subtopics that affect anti-aging, such as nutrition, exercise, stress levels, and so on. So creating content on all the subtopics around your main topic gives your website topical authority. And that can help you dominate a niche. This is what modern SEO is all about, developing content around your main topic using clusters or groups of relevant keywords. So the question is, how exactly do you cluster keywords? Well, I'm glad you asked. Let's look at some of the best ways to do this. Once again, you may want to bookmark this section. One option is to gather topics based on your keyword list. In lesson 2, you learned how to categorize keywords during the research phase. For example, you could categorize your keywords into the different zones of the Zen matrix and start your SEO campaign with the opportunity keywords, or the Candyland zone if you found any. To create categories from your keyword lists, you group them into topics that match the user's search intent and your website structure. So the very first step of keyword clustering is to gather related topics based on your keyword list. For example, if one of your transactional keywords is used car for sale, consider that as one of your main topics rather than a single keyword for which you will build a landing page. There are countless subtopics that support the topic used car. Things like how to test a used car, Kia versus Toyota used car comparison, what is a good mileage on a used car, etc. Remember, it's all about building topical authority, and that means covering as many related angles as you can in order to be seen as an authority on the topic. Once you come up with a list of subtopics, you simply go through your keyword list and categorize or group all the keywords that relate to each subtopic. And now you have a group of clusters for each topic. Each cluster is a group of keywords destined for one page, broadening the scope of that page so that it can rank for multiple terms. This results in better overall ranking because your website has supporting content covering related topics. And ranking, of course, is the result of the search engine recognizing your website as an authority on the topic. Another option is to cluster keywords by search intent. Being an authority on a topic does not equal traffic if your topics don't align with the user's search intent. For example, if you have a website with information on every type of treadmill on the planet, that does not make a good resource for somebody searching with the intent to buy a treadmill. When it comes to the topics themselves, each topic can cover different pieces of content for different search intents. For example, if your topic is coffee machine, the subtopic manual espresso coffee machine would belong to a transactional search intent. The best 10 coffee machines would be a comparison, and espresso making tips would be informational. Search intent exists when you see search volume for the keywords in your topics. That's how you ensure that your topics align with search intent. But what about the keywords in the cluster that have very low search volume? Should you create content for those? My advice is if the keyword cluster contains high search volume keywords, then those low search volume keywords will add support to those high search volume keywords on the same page, which is a great way of accumulating topical authority on your website. Now, you may be wondering, if your transactional keyword is manual espresso coffee machine in London, why do you need content on espresso making tips? Well, you're about to discover why in the next section, when we dive into ToFu, MoFu and BoFu to see the impact of keyword clustering on your customer's journey. So yet another option is to cluster keywords based on ToFu, MoFu and BoFu. Let's start by defining what these terms mean, and remember to bookmark this section for your reference. ToFu, MoFu and BoFu stand for top of the funnel, middle of the funnel and bottom of the funnel. And yes, we're talking about a sales funnel here. These terms define different parts of the buyer's journey. Here's the thing to keep in mind. Search behavior changes as it progresses through the sales funnel. For example, if you just heard about intermittent fasting, your searches would begin with informational searches because you'd be looking for information on the topic. If you decided that this was something for you or something you wanted to try, your search behavior would change. You would start to look for information on programs and maybe even supplements. Your search intent changed from informational to transactional. So if you can create content for all the parts of the funnel, you can guide your prospects towards the transactional content. Or if you prefer, your offer. Catering for your visitors' every need boosts your topical authority in the eyes of the search engine. And it also increases trust in your brand in the eyes of your prospect, which of course ultimately leads to more conversions. And this is why content on the topic espresso making tips helps your transactional keyword, manual espresso coffee machine in London. So let's dive into each funnel stage. ToFu content helps improve the awareness of your product or service by providing useful information related to your topic, but not really about what you're selling. In other words, your espresso making tips article can provide great tips and include a mention to the coffee machine you are selling. The conversion rate for transactions at this stage of the funnel will be pretty low, but it does increase trust and topical authority on your website. BoFu content is the opposite. The conversion rate for transactions might be high because at this stage of the funnel, searchers are looking to buy. Just keep in mind that the traffic volume for this type of content is usually much lower than for ToFu content. And it takes time to rank high on the SERPs for this type of content because there is always competition. MoFu content is something in the middle. It narrows down the audience that's most aligned to doing business with you by conveying that you have the solution to the problem the readers are facing. Now, your cluster topics may have content that focuses only on one of those funnel stages, but you can still cover aspects of each funnel stage into a single piece of content. For example, a case study on which creatine product is best for adding muscle that concludes in 3 recommended brands covers aspects of each funnel stage. Which funnel stage your content fits into really depends on the search intent gathered during the keyword research stage. That said, there is no right or wrong way to cluster keywords into topics. Content is always dynamic, so there's plenty of room for you to get creative. Now let's wrap this up by considering some of the benefits of clustering keywords. To begin with, clustering maximizes the SEO performance of your keyword list. By ranking topics, you create more chances to be ranked higher for your groups of keywords rather than ranking for individual keywords. Ranking single pages for groups of keywords makes for sustainable rankings. On the other hand, ranking single pages for single keywords is not sustainable because there is always competition. Which means other websites with more resources or content or topical authority can always take over your position. But when you rank for a topic and you're seen as an authority on that topic, your competitors need time to build their own topical authority in order to compete against you. Another great advantage of clustering is that it forces you to create a good long-term content plan. With old-school SEO, your plan really was how many articles you could publish each month. However, when you're creating content on a topic and subtopics that support that topic, your entire content plan becomes a focused effort to produce pieces of content with a clear purpose. And one final benefit of keyword clustering is that we can often better understand the search intent of the prospect. By gathering topics related to your product or service or core offer, you may find the search intent that you would have otherwise missed in your keyword research. By analyzing everything at the topic level rather than the keyword level, you get to walk in your customer's shoes and discover the types of questions they're asking the search engine as they progress through the different points of the sales funnel. In the next session, we'll be covering SEO content development. I'll see you there.